I just want to know that if you are willing to go on record today as someone who studied in Don Bosco, Chennai, and admit that Good Shepherd girls and Church Park girls fought for the love of Don Bosco boys. Are you willing to go on record and say it, Dinesh Karthik?
I think so, isn't it? It's a bit of a fact. I'm sure you've done it as well. You've been part
because
of it.
Because I was a Good Shepherd girl who didn't do it, so I know. Also, how is Brendan McCullum? It's the first time he's coach, right? For all this season.
Yeah, for KKR.
Yeah.
He's a fabulous guy. I get along very well with him. He's got a great sense of humor. He's a lovely guy. New Zealanders are very nice. In New Zealand, there are more sheep than human beings, so they are very nice.
Just have you ever asked him about those tattoos and whether he just made them himself? Do you ever feel those little low quality tattoos? I felt I don't understand why.
Low quality is actually of very highest quality. I feel he's got his date of birth, he's got his children's names, he's got his favorite
some weird map and all. There is
map is I think all the countries that he's visited. Then he has a horse, which is his passion. He has a 20-acre farm that he lives on, where he breeds horses and he wants to send them to races. And, you know, he's serious into that. And he spends a lot of money on that.
Yeah, I just saw photographs of Brendan McCullum's tattoo and I have to agree with DK. This seems high quality stuff, man. Anu, I mean, yours is being like dismissive of the KKR's coaches' tattoos for no reason.
No. He is lovely. But I'm just, the tattoos are a bit suspect if you ask me. Huh? I was like, should we trust a man with these tattoos?
Okay, we got a lot of questions pouring in, so I'll just read out a few comments. Monish Ahuja says, thanks, Saurabh, for bringing Dinesh on the stream. Respect for him, a great player and a real hero. Pratik Rathod says, DK, you're the best also. Om Charan says, Dinesh, I love your cricketing style and send my regards to Abhishek Nair. Lots of people, big fans, Anirudh Deshpande, DK OP. Do you know the meaning of OP?
OP?
It's my favorite. Yeah. Favorite question to ask people.
No.
I'm just trying to figure out how closely related we are age-wise, because I'm 38 years old and I had no idea. So I was wondering, like, does everybody not? OP is overpowered, which is like a gaming term, which means like it's a positive thing. It's what I've learned from the last 1.5 months of doing this show.
Oh, so it's a YouTube jargon, is it? I mean, I haven't heard of that one before.
Yeah, it's a gaming jargon, apparently.
Please, now that you're a YouTube sensation, you should know this, DK.
I feel like a vlogger here now. A YouTube sensation. I think just now, Chahil got engaged to a girl who's very good at vlogging and who's an integral part of YouTube. So, I'm the next one to join the list. YouTube sensation. You know, I want to ask you this. I have to find out. I haven't made the effort. They said that my video is the most watched sports video. That has to be wrong, right? I'm sure there are sports like basketball or football that has been watched a million more times than this. Can't be.
But there are more Indians than Americans. So for sure, there is no doubt.
I think football. Easy. Football is globally watched, not just Americans.
Basketball, but in comparison to basketball.
Is it the most watched sports video or is it the most watched cricket video? Cricket video, the interesting part of my friend sent it. The most watched cricket video number one is the last over. The most watched cricket video number two is the 19th over. So I was like, wow, that's interesting. Why would anybody watch the 19th over so many times?
By the way, you might be right. You actually might be right, because the most views for a football highlights video is Portugal versus Spain 2018 FIFA World Cup Russia, which got half of the views that you got. You got 170 million.
I think that person is pretty correct though.
Wow. I'm going to Google this for absolutely no reason. The last time we did the one with Harsha, we were trying to figure out whether Clive Lloyd's somebody referenced.
This was a forward sent to me. The most watched sports video, the most watched cricket video ever, the most watched cricket video ever, number two, the most liked sports video. Apparently, it's some 1 million or 100 million. I don't know what it is. I'm like, okay. What do I do?
DK, just say thank you. Just say thank you.
Yeah. I'm going to monitor.
Or just say you're welcome.
I'm going to monetize it through YouTube now. Yo, come on, yeah.
By the way, for basketball, I checked for basketball. The most watched basketball video is quite funny. It's Peter Parker versus Flash basketball scene in The Amazing Spider-Man. That's the most watched basketball video, which is completely not a highlight reel. But yeah, I think you are the most watched sports video in the world. That's crazy. Wow. We are both looking at you in a new light altogether. This is like...
Can I ask you one serious question now?
Yeah.
Like, are there, like, do you ever feel like there are some losses that you will never be able to get over, like, on the cricket field? Or are you more like, okay, it's happened, let's move on, that's it? Are you good with handling loss?
Yeah, I think I'm good with handling losses. I don't let it linger on for too long. I think, I'm one of those guys who tries really hard before the match and does everything possible during the game and then just lets the result be. I think it's okay. I mean, I'm not one of those guys who dwell on it, honestly. The close ones hurt. Like, I think the last final, CSK, it would have hurt a little bit. It'll sting because, you know, you lose by one run. I mean, that margin is very hard to, you know, accept and understand. But that's what sport is, you know. Sometimes it teaches you a lot of things that you're not aware of.
It's an interesting question that Anu's asked, which is that I sometimes think that we tend to not recognize that being successful in sport doesn't necessarily always involve victory. You know what I'm saying? Like, even if you've reached the final, that's still, I mean, you're still the second best team. So I think do you think people tend to disregard the fact that that in itself is quite an achievement to get there?
No, I think I'll not forget this. I think history always remembers champions. So no, my second best is just a consolation that you live with. So you need to make peace with that. But the rest of the world will never remember you for that. Everybody will remember the fact that Mumbai has won 4 times. It's very hard for people to know how many times Chennai has reached the final. That's a big number as well. So, history always remembers the champions. I mean, you know, some losses are really hard to swallow. Like, last year, Roger Federer losing to Novak Djokovic in the final of Wimbledon. He had 2 match points. And to squander it and end up losing, it's a really hard one. It'll give you some sleepless nights. In fact, I've heard an interview where he's spoken about it and he said he still can't make peace with it. But, you know, that's life. You're not going to get everything. He was voted the richest cricketer. Not voted, given the richest cricketer, richest sportsman tag. And then, you know, you lose the Wimbledon final, which he's not able to accept. So, that's the good and bad of it. I think you need to learn. I think as a sportsman, you learn to live with it. It's okay.
Like Nadal has 19 Grand Slam titles, but couldn't work an Insta live. You know, so it's nice when you see these human sides of champions.